Speaking in front of a crowd is considered the number one fear of the average person. I found that amazing. Number two was death. Death is number two? This means to the average person, if you have to be at a funeral, you would rather be in the casket than doing the eulogy.
That is true for some, though. Jerry Seinfeld makes it sound funny, but one of the most common phobias, studies suggest, is the fear of public speaking. And now, as we spend more time on gadgets instead of face-to-face communication, are we hurting our ability to communicate in public? Deirdre Van Ness is a certified world-class speaking coach whose goal is to help people come to terms with this common fear. You know, he does poke fun of it, but that is true for so many of us.
Oh yeah, I used to be one of those people. I was terrified.
I know, we were just talking off camera. You said that you it's ironic that you do this now for a living.
Yes.
How
yes.
did you overcome that?
You know, one of the things I realized, Zach, is that fear is totally normal. Fear is not the problem. The problem is the meaning we attach to fear. Most people, when they feel afraid, what do they say to themselves? Uh-oh, something's gonna go bad.
Right.
I'm gonna fail.
Right.
But that's
I can't
not
do
true.
It.
Right. Your feelings can't predict a result. So the key is to be fiercely protective of your self-talk, even if you don't believe it, and make it positive in the hours and even days before a presentation.
Do you recall the first time it became comfortable or you're like, I can do this, I can actually get there?
You
do you remember what that subject was that you were talking? Or were you standing in front of a mirror just talking?
Well, I was speaking about fear. I became an expert in fear, actually, before I became
because
an expert.
Because of this?
No. Well,
okay.
in part, actually. There
right.
was some in there.
Right.
But I became an expert in fear, and I wanted to speak to everybody. And my fear of not helping people with this message was greater than my fear of speaking, and I kind of just pushed myself to get over it.
Now, number two, when we talk about fear is normal, the second step is have a foolproof opening.
Yes. So the time that people are most nervous is in the beginning of a presentation.
Right.
And that's when people are going to decide if they tune you in or tune you out. So come in prepared to engage them right away. The simplest way to do it is to open with a question that's relevant to the content that's coming, one that gets them nodding their heads yes in agreement with you, and one that gets them thinking about themselves.
Which goes into number three, which is the audience's emotion.
Yeah, so one of the things that presenters do is that we want people to get our message, right? We want them to understand, so we hammer people with facts and figures and statistics. Those are needed. But it's also important that your audience feels your message. So the way to make them feel it is to interweave stories throughout those facts and figures.
So don't get up there and just wing it. Have a purpose.
Oh yeah, you definitely have to have a purpose. I definitely recommend that you write out your talk in advance, rehearse it. It doesn't have to be said word for word, but you do need to know where you're going and what you're transitioning to.
So I know, Deirdre, you say there's bad news and good news to becoming an effective public speaker.
Yeah, so the bad news is, like I had to do, you just have to get out and do it. There's
just
no way to
it.
Get better unless you do it.
Right.
But the good news is people think you have to be born really good at this, and that's not true.
That's
there's
not true.
A science behind constructing presentations that are what I call crazy good, and that levels the playing field for everybody.
You know, there's so many people in my industry too that everybody's like, oh, you can do this. You talk to a camera every day. No, we talk to a camera every day.
Right.
We're not talking to crowds of people. And I've come across and I've become friends with people in the industry who are legit, this is one of their fears as well.
Yeah.
But you just gotta do it.
You just gotta do
it. Any other quick little tips?
Gosh, I'd say, you know what, just be passionate.
Just be passionate.
Just be passionate. Just worry about being passionate and just giving your audience all you
awesome.
Got.
Awesome. Thank you so much for coming in.
Thank
we, of
you.
Course, will post all of her tips on our website. Her website is called Crazy Good Talks, but those tips will be on our website, yeah. And that's at carelevin.com after the show.